canyons there. So let's walk up the next ridge. Okay, there we are. It's the first little section. Start to see the guy, see the alien? Proves that aliens are here, right there. There's your alien. So let's get up here. This is where it starts. And you know, the stuff that's on the north side has always been intriguing to me because it's like, tell you what, I'm baffled by that every time I come out here because, again, you might have thought it's just some crazy drawing, but once you see that in a science book, you know exactly what that is. It's not even a question. It's not even a, you know, an estimation where you look at a lot of these petroglyphs and you're like, well, I don't know what they really want meant, you know, if it was a spiritual thing or...
Yeah, the fibers then turn into strands, but they stay together, even though, you know, so they work together as one.
This is probably, to me, one of the most unique places in Agua Fria, and that is Pato. Thanks, sir.
There's only a handful of duck petroglyphs in the United States, and they're in this area. Whether, you know, they had mallards fly into the creeks and the tinahasas or what. And he's well endowed, and he has a big stick. He's got two big sticks. So the shaman would have been in there. There's no doubt in my mind.
Brewing up the stuff.
Pretty cool. Okay, if I'm remembering correctly. Make sure you look at this deer on this side of this. With all the dots. On a fire and put water in it and get steam. And the steam would start to make the material pliable. And then what they would do is straighten the arrows right here. This is pretty rare. You don't see, there's another one over here somewhere. That's a pretty rare thing. You do not see that. Man, there ain't been nobody here, Art. Probably because of the road, but...